come here today with some lived-in experience, obviously not only from being within the justice system and being incarcerated, but also because I raised my daughter in prison, well, her first nearly 4 years anyway.
My journey to prison was long and featured both drug-related and white-collar offending. And I served a 27-month period of incarceration at a range of prisons, including 9 months in maximum security facilities.
I walked into the system only experiencing domestic violence and obviously mental health. And I found that there was a big wall, you know, stopping people from receiving help whilst in there.
I'm a person who works full time. I've now been out of prison for some 4 years, and I've been able to rebuild a life that doesn't feature offending and is meaningful.
How different are the impact of incarceration on women prisoners from men prisoners?
What women are coping hard is being separated from their family and their children. Now, men deal with that emotion differently. So as soon as women are taken away from their families and their children, that's their sentence.
I'm assuming that expanding the spent conviction scheme is also enabling people to not have to disclose their criminal past when seeking employment.
Whether someone discloses on a criminal record check or not, there are many ways in this modern world to learn about someone's past. And if you put someone in a situation where they haven't shared something in the beginning of their employment relationship and it subsequently comes up, then regardless of whether legally they were allowed to or not, it has a profound effect on their trustworthiness, on their relationship with their employer, and potentially on their job security.
So when you say that we, and magistrates in particular, should take a closer look at some of the reasons, some of the causes of a crime that's committed by Victorian women, in particular, you're referring to family violence and the prevalence of family violence in the community?
I think so. Yeah, I definitely am.
You talked in your initial comments about a lack of support and how the approach wasn't therapeutic. I'd love your thoughts on what can be done better.
I have studied to want to work with people that are in the same situation as me. And I don't understand that the officers that are in the prison systems that deal with us every day don't need to have that. How do they not be taught how to deal with women who have come from violence, or how to use strength-based approaches, or want to build people up to see people walk out of the system strong, rather than saying, well, you know, remember why you're here, you're a number, you're this, you're that.
It really is great to be able to see and hear from someone who has a lived experience.
One of the most crucial, pivotal moments in my journey and my rehabilitation was hearing victim impact statements at my sentencing of those who were impacted by my offending, and that had a profound effect on me. Community protection and rehabilitation are synergistic. They do support each other, and the cheapest, most long-standing way to secure increased protection for the community is to rehabilitate people genuinely into a positive, aspirational life.